Recently, I bought some more lights for making my YouTube videos that make effects like this much more interesting. A couple of weeks ago for work, I went on a shoot in Barcelona for a commercial, and I noticed the DOP and the gaffers on set were using a type of light that I'd never really seen before. And that type of light in question is one of these. These are LED tube lights. They're fairly new on the scene, and there's lots of new ones coming out all the time at the moment that are kind of pushing the boundaries of what the lighting technology can do. These particular ones are by a company called Nanlight. This is the PavoTube 30X. But this video isn't about this specific light, it's just about tube lights or LED lights in general. I'm not sponsored by Nanlight, they don't know I'm making this video, and these certainly weren't sent to me. I paid full price for these out of my own money. I should just quickly mention that the assets from this video, if you're interested, are on my Patreon. So you can get your hands on both of the pieces of footage, so that's the green screen and the raw plate of the flashing for the Thor effect. And then I also made some custom assets of the lightning bolts for this video. There's three different variations at different speeds, so you can download those and use them in your own projects as well. So the idea behind this is it's an LED tube and it can be controlled with an app. So I can turn this on, for example, and it looks like this. The app allows you to have complete control over the color and intensity of the light. So currently I'm just flicking through different colors on the color wheel. And as you can see, it's changing in real time. I can also dim it or make it brighter. So they come in really handy for just basic lighting setups like the one that I've got here for this video at the moment. But as we know, my channel is predominantly about visual effects, and so this wouldn't be a very VFX video if I was just talking about lighting. So the reason I bought these lights specifically for making VFX videos is they have a load of effect modes built into them, and you can make some custom preset ones as well that are really, really good for emulating practical light on set and then adding visual effects later. A perfect example is the clip that I showed at the beginning. That was using a preset on these lights called Welding, which is basically emulating the light of a welder. I got two of these, so there's this one obviously that I'm holding, and then there's another one up here just out of frame that's currently lighting me. So I put one of these on each side of me, set them both to welding, and had different flicker speeds on both so they had a bit of variation, and used that to get some realistic lighting interaction in camera that would then help when I went to add the visual effects on top later. So here we are again on my phone. Currently I'm just looking at the color mode. There's a more generic one that's just for controlling the brightness and the color temperature. Then there's the HSI mode, which is the one that I was currently in. And then the one that I'm particularly interested in is the effect mode, which we have here. And as you can see, it's defaulted to the welding effect, which I had it on last time. I just turn that off so I don't give myself some sort of seizure. This might turn back on actually, but if I start mucking about with this, yeah, there we go. The top control is for setting the range of how bright and dark the light should go in the flickering. Then you can change the speed of the flickering. So something like this is obviously pretty nuts. I had it on quite low, so it felt like it was just flashes of lightning. And then at the bottom, you can set the color temperature and the saturation and everything as well. So for example, I can set it to a different color. As well as welding, you can see there's loads of different types of effects here. Another one that I think will come in really handy for VFX is candle slash fire. So as you can imagine, this is emulating like the flickering of a fire. Changing the speed will obviously make a difference to how intense the fire feels. I think I might actually turn the first light off so that you can see what this is doing a bit better. There we go. So now we're in purely effect mode. There's another one that's great, which is a police car effect. So this goes between blue and red flashing. There's a paparazzi one, which is kind of emulating camera flashes, which I also think is really cool. Keeping in mind, obviously, these are named for certain uses, but you could obviously use this effect to do pretty much anything that would require this kind of look. Another really cool one that is obviously very useful for visual effects is explosion. So I can press the trigger button and it will just set it off. So you can imagine if you timed this with the actors interacting with it on set, this would give them something to reference with their acting for timing. And then obviously this also adds the practical light, which is fantastic when it comes to adding the visual effects later, because you don't have to try and fake it. When it comes to adding light in post, it never really works quite as well as if you can just get it in camera. So adding some practical light interaction from something like this is a much better idea. This is another scene that I set up. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. This is another scene that I set up really quickly just using my green screen earlier. I'm not using any of the effects modes in this, but it was really handy to be able to sit down and look at the monitor on my camera and just sit with my phone and dial in the color and the intensity of the backlight that I wanted. I also used a fan that I had in my living room for both of these to add some wind interaction, which makes it feel a bit more powerful. And for this scene that I'm now doing, it looks like I'm outside. So I turned off all the lights in my living room, added a nice backlight, which I knew would feel like it was coming from the city lights that I was going to be replacing the background with later in post. And then once it's looking cool, I can take it into Nuke and Blender and add the visual effects. So I replaced the background with just a quick photo I found on Google Images of some city lights, as you can see. I keyed off the highlights of all the lights in the buildings and then ran a slow-moving noise texture through them, which helps it to feel a bit more alive, like the lights are twinkling. I rendered a quick ledge out of Blender just so I could have something to sit on in the shot, and then added a 3D camera move and put the green screen footage of me on a card in 3D space so that it would move with the camera. So like I said, I've got two of these and I'm going to be using them for all of my YouTube videos going forward. And I think they're going to be really handy for adding some extra production value to my visual effects shots. Also, the fact that they're battery powered is really convenient because it means I don't have to worry about plugging them in, so I can take them on more remote shoots. And even just for shooting videos in my flat, it's more convenient. These particular ones are actually quite expensive, but you can certainly get cheaper variations that do a very similar thing. From a quick search on Amazon, I found a few alternative options that are much cheaper. So Aputure do the ALMC LED panel, which is like a little battery powered LED, and that has pretty much all of the same effects as these tubes built into it, and it's controllable with an app as well. Obviously that's not going to be quite as bright as these LED tubes, but it will still help to add some interactive lighting into your videos if you're interested. And actually there's an even better option, which is from Small Rig, which is pretty much the same thing. It's a small LED panel. I found it at £70 on Amazon. Again, it's controllable with an app, so it's nice and flexible, and it has a load of built-in effects very similar to these lights. Just a little bit of housekeeping for anyone that still actually made it this far into the video. You might notice that I'm in a different setup to normal. If you're in the Discord server or you read one of the posts that I posted a few weeks ago, you will know that I actually moved house. I bought a flat here in London and I moved into it about 4 weeks ago now. So that's why there's been a bit of a gap on my YouTube channel in terms of content. But I'm now very happy to say that I'm in. My internet is working, which is one of the main reasons why there was a gap in content. And I've built my absolute dream office, so my setup is better than ever. And I'm really excited to start using it to make more YouTube videos. So stay tuned, there's gonna be a lot of stuff coming. And I'm looking forward to making some awesome videos in this new really creative space. Thanks very much for watching. Again, the assets are on Patreon if you're interested, and I'll see you in the next one.